Alright, so hello, hello. I'm a little depressed today, sorry. I didn't get up early, I didn't walk the dog, I've been staying inside, and to compensate, I joined the God group of artists. There's a group, a meetup group of the gods only, and so I feel a little better to be like reconciled with just joining the group, because my goodness, why would we ever need to contact each other, you know? Because we're gods. So, well, there it goes. Funny. And so then, in the funniness of everything, yeah, I didn't walk the dog. I'm just a jerk. I'm just a jerk today. But overall, in compensation, I installed, I had to just shred my machine to death again, this Linux box. And so I put the brand new, again, reinstalls, and it worked out. But do not go into the fstab. This is a warning. The fstab configuration file, if you're using Linux Ubuntu, do not go in there and fiddle around with it and think it's gonna just be great, because all I ended up doing was just wrecking it, and so I had to end up reinstalling anyway and moving files. And so I ended up, because I don't have enough of these, you know what I mean? These little, I have like 40 gigabytes of like a lot of my artwork and photography, and this 40 gigabytes, you know, it doesn't fit on one of these little USBs. And so it's like an impossible move. It's better to go operating, partition to partition. So it's been, anyway, I did it. And so now I've got four partitions, and I only have one that's completely just a criminal that I have to redo. And I don't know how it happens. I don't know how it happens. I'm not sh even sure, because it's not a virus. I didn't get a virus on the machine. It was a disk write error. And so a disk write error that just opened me up a black screen, and it said disk error. You know, and once you get the disk error, it's like, well, it's over. It's over. I have to put a new one in there, and so there it goes. I put a new, what do we call it? Yeah, a new reinstallation, and then hope to find the files after. And so there they were. It all worked out. And in the interim, I joined the God group. And I did do some holiday shopping with my aunt, and so that's kind of fun. Yeah, it was kind of fun, but not fun actually. The holiday shopping event was not fun. I really am gonna make a vlog next about. I'm gonna speak in French, because I've been neglecting it. But yeah, when you're not prepared, and you go shopping, and it's like, I had no idea we were shopping for so many people all at once, and it just became like a snowball of event, and we weren't. I wasn't ready, and so I was a very bad helper, shopping wise. Had I known before, none of that would have gone on. I absolutely, gosh dang it. I didn't know. I didn't know. So, yeah. So she was a sneaker. She snuck up on me as an aunt, and just started all of a sudden becoming a holiday shopper. So maybe that's something I can give as advice. If you know somebody that is older, maybe try to make a list before you go, because you know, just keep that in mind. Because that became just a terrible event. A terrible situation over sizes of what the women wear. You know, they're different sizes, and it just became way too confusing. Way too confusing, especially since, you know, in all of these addled brains of these older women, you know, a size small, a size large, a pink one, you know, whatever, you know, all of these different things going on. Yeah, try to write it down, write a list down. So that's my advice for the day. On that situation, what was really the deal? Yeah, so it's the fstab. Sorry, Linux. There's a Linux group, a meetup group here in Dallas. I can't really find one. You're like engineers or something, so I won't join that one. So I don't know. There's not really a Linux group for people like me, I suppose. So forget you. I'll just talk about it. Yeah, I'm really disappointed in the fstab configuration file, because I was there and everything was looking so cool, and I was like, well, I've got the default set there at 0-1 for the main primary, and then I have the logical setup as 0-2, and I figured that that would be adequate. But no, there was no access. It didn't give me access back in, and I'm ending up with this skipping, this skip to get through the reboot. And then I'm ending up with one more thing saying try manual, and manual just drops me back down at the cutesy little prompt, back at square one again. And hopefully at that prompt you actually have access through with your password. If you don't, you have to go into the init. You have not the init. You have to get into the recovery. The recovery link through, and when you go through the recovery startup, then you drop into its configuration file and you change the splash screen. So this is really at the very base minimum of it. You have to change your splash screen into and get rid of that. And instead of RO, you have to go to read write, and then you go into the init with a bin bash in an init equals bin a slash bin slash bash. And once you do that, you can have password access again. But for some reason, I have even had my password file just taken over as some kind of no access back in and through. So these are just like, I just feel like this is ridiculous sometimes, this Linux box. I don't know. As much as I like fiddling with it, sometimes it's just a mess, just a mess. And so yeah, so I'm having a few temporary what do you call those? Oh, and then it has like a temporary error. Now it's a slash TMP on entry, and so once I have that there, I can't even get through with the skip or the manual version for editing. So if you get the slash TMP error, it says my TMP file isn't even present. And I've gone in and I've tried to make the dir of the TMP file, and it's not even reading, it's not finding it. So something completely ruinous happened, and I don't know how it happened. That's the worst of it. I don't know how it happened, because I don't think it's a virus. I actually install very little software, hardware, whatever you call it, N not hardware, whatever those application things. So I don't know. I don't know what did it. So I'm in the slash TMP wonder, and I'm not really happy about that. And so reluctantly, instead of trying to fix it because I can't find the answer, I have to end up with a reinstall. And I've only had this installation grouping a very short while, so I'm kind of bummed out about it. It just feels like I'm under attack, It just feels like I'm under attack, I don't know. So yeah. I don't know. Something about memory all the time. I don't know. I'm just bummed out. I'm just bummed out. I don't know. I use very little. I use very little with the machine. I use the PDF. I use the little Office, the Microsoft, not the Microsoft, the other one, the Libre Office. I use that one, and for a few little things. I have had, it doesn't crash during any of those moments. This was really just I started the machine and it was a disk write error immediately. I'm like, what the heck? How does that happen on a regular reboot? Yeah, something seriously went down on my little machine. So anyway, so it's all repaired. It's all repaired, and the files were found, and so it's no big dilemma of a suicide here. But yeah, gosh dang it, gosh dang it, don't pin your hopes on this thing. Just don't pin your hopes on it, because it's terrible. It's terrible when you have your files out here and then they're just destroyed. Because sometimes these reinstalls, if you do them wrong, you can if you reformat over any, you lose every file. You lose every file. If there is a way that you can reassign that you can reassign and reinstall and keep the files that are in your home directory. And in order to do that, it's still scary. It's still a scary moment, so I'm not loving that. Yeah, because it's what it does is it goes in the very back of it, and it gives you a brand new Linux reinstallation, and then it tries to keep those files that you had that were from the home dir on, and that is sweet. However, it's just the writing, it's the terminology, and it's the way it's been done by the initial, I guess it's Ubuntu, the programmers right there. It needs to be a little clearer. It needs to be a little like, hey, you really get to keep your home directory and all those files, because not very many people have files underneath the home directory. They don't have a lot of files hanging out and et cetera and all of that. That's just going to be some programs they're going to have to reinstall. When we're talking a real true breakdown of your system, you want the files. That is the main thing. The software reinstallation programs and finding them, that's like secondary. That's secondary to your actual files in importance. So we really need to somehow have the wording done there a little bit better when you're making a reinstallation. That yeah, for sure you're gonna get your save all of them, and go ahead and understandably do not reformat, because if you reformat, you end up with a complete wipeout. The whole thing is completely destroyed. You lose all of it. It goes blank. You know what I mean? So. And then even choosing if you want extension for, or if you want to use NTFS. So, well, great. So some help I am. I'm some system administrator I am with Linux. I'm just like, follow Teresa, and you'll just end up being like, let's just blow up our boxes on for fun. It seems like that's what I do recently. Watch themselves implode. Well, gosh dang it. I don't know it. So I ended up talking about Linux, so I guess that'll be the gist of this one. And, yeah, I don't know. I'm making a lot of these today.